We are going to use MATLAB to obtain the relative maxima of this function. Recall that an analytical method for determining critical points is compute the partials and set the two partials equal to 0, all right? And then after that, when you get the solutions, they are your critical points, then compute the values of these second derivatives and obtain the discriminant D. And remember, you have done these questions just by hand. That is, if D is greater than 0 and the second derivative with respect to X at that point is greater than 0, then we have a relative min, etc., etc. So you can easily recall that. So we shall enter our symbolic functions, okay, symbolic function rather. Remember, that's what you did when you wanted to enter a function symbolically, and this function is x to the 4 plus 2 times y to the 4. Okay, here we have to be cautious. I'm sorry. 2 times y to the 4, then minus 12 xy square, so x times y square, and then at the end we have minus 20 y square, right? Okay, so here we go, we have our okay, I made a mistake. All right, let's fix it. What did I do bad? I just forgot putting the star over here, right? The multiplication sign. Okay, good. So here we have the function now, okay? Now what we shall do is that we shall go ahead and define the let's define our partials here, the partial differential, the partial derivatives. That is, we are defining the derivative of the function with respect to x as fx and the derivative with respect to y as fy. Okay, all right. Now, the next thing that we will do is that we would want to solve for the two equations by setting these partials equal to 0. So, this is how we will obtain the solution that we shall, you know, let AB be a critical point. And what we want to do is we want to solve for them, and very likely in here we are going to get what? We are going to get, you know, the exact values may not be very pleasant to look at, okay? So we will go ahead and find approximate values. Let's get approximate values of these numbers, okay, or the critical points. All right, so what we get, 0, 0 is a critical point, then 3.6247, 3.9842, 3.6247 and negative 3.9842, they are critical points. Okay, so now we have to check at which of them we are able to find max or min, or, you know, which ones are answered by this test that we are using. In order to find the discriminant, let us go ahead and give the program the definition for the second derivatives. That is, fxx is the second derivative of f with respect to fx, second derivative of f with respect to x, and fxy would be the derivative of fx with respect to y, and fyy will be the derivative of fy with respect to y. Okay, now we will define our d. That who is d? Remember, I'm just taking it from our earlier narration. So here we go. So we have defined d. Now what remains to be done is the evaluation of this discriminant and the second derivative of x at the points that we get in this manner. This time we shall substitute this value of the critical point, okay? The coordinates of this particular critical point, precisely speaking. And here, what's the answer for d? The value of d is a positive. That's all we cared about at the moment, right? Okay, and let's try to see. Okay, yep. Now we want to compute this for the second derivative of f with respect to x, and here that is also a positive number. So what do we conclude? That we have a relative minima at this point. And if you want, you can go ahead and look at these values for the other one. Even though we see our value of x is positive and all the powers on y are even, so we are going to, I think, get the same conclusion, and we are getting the same conclusion. And same thing we should get for these values, right? Okay, so here I'm getting it for this one, and there you go, this is positive again. Okay, so what we have at zero, this did not tell us anything, and for this particular point, it told us that we have a relative min, and the same thing here. Okay, and we can go ahead and look at a graph. Doesn't cost us anything. So let's see how, what would the graph suggest. So as I said, we are going to look at a graph, and I'm going to go by easy surf, keeping things easy. It's about the conclusion of the course. Okay. So we are, let's go to the window 0505 for now, because we saw one of the, one of the set was in this range. And here we go. We will go ahead and rotate it. One moment. So you can see this here, that we do have a relative minimum here. Give me a moment, let me just drag this down so that we can see. Okay, so this is what I meant. We have a relative min here, and we can go ahead and graphically visualize it for the other critical number as well. Okay, now let's look at what's going on near zero. Okay, at least graphically. All right, so we will go for, go for easy surface F. We want to stay near zero. Okay, so let's go like negative 1, 1. Okay, and oops, what happened? Oh, I forgot to close the bracket, right? Okay, sorry about that. Okay, so here we go, and here is a graph. Well, we can see that looks like a saddle point here, but let's see this portion with a little better view, and we may do this. Look at it with, let me change the window for this one right here and see what we get. So looks like we do have a saddle point here, and I think you will agree. So well, graphically we can determine that we have a saddle point at zero for x equals zero, y equals zero, or there is a saddle point at the origin. All right, Now I'm going to just going to ask you a very similar simple example, okay, to work using this method.